Hello, and welcome to this video tutorial on this channel that will be showing you how to create a custom optic for Insurgency, or Insurgency 2, however you call it, on Steam. So, we're going to be going through how to, first of all, collect these textures and all that from Insurgency itself, or you could just pull it from the workshop itself. I'm saying way too much. After this, you can post this to the workshop if you really do want to. It really does depend up to you. But after that, we're gonna, show you how to do everything and whatnot. So the first thing that you want to do when creating a custom optic is getting these two applications right here, or executables, however you want to call it. So, they both do, helpful and all that. So, one application will allow you to open VBKs, and what a VBK is a file that is basically what runs the game, where the textures are held, where the models are held, where the sound files are held, absolutely everything, and I'll show you that right now. Now, the reason why I'm making this tutorial is because I just made a custom optic. And we could just kind of go down to it was a bitch. And it wasn't fun. So this is a custom optic that I just made right here. It's pretty fun to make it and all that. It's just, it takes a very long time. At least it was for me. I had to figure it out. There's no tutorials or anything like that. I tried searching up as many bloody tutorials as I could, but there's hardly anything. So anyway, we're going to jump straight into it. I'm going to show you what a VPK is. So what a VPK is this. So this is Armor Invest HUD. So this is a workshop file. VPK, so this is your file. I'm going to go down to my one right here, as I'm going to use this as an example. We're going to throw this into here. So when we throw it into here, what comes up is these folders. Root, Materials, Models, Weapons, Optics, and an Alcan. So this is the actual texture itself. So we're going to throw this onto the desktop here. And then after that, we're going to throw this into here. And bingo, we have the scope. And this is what these two applications allow you to do. So it allows you to open up VPKs, and not only that, the VTF files as well. So you want these two applications. I'll probably have them in the description, maybe not, I don't know whether I'm stupid or not, but either way you can just search up their names, GCF Scape and VTF Edit. So yeah, you can just search up those names if I don't manage to put them in or not. So, in order to start this off, we're just going to close these two applications and piss that off. So the first step to it all is starting out with your texture, I guess. So I just showed you how to grab a texture. I'll quickly show you again, actually. But Photoshop is going to be a bitch, of course. We're going to throw that away. So in order to grab a texture, you want to go into GCF Scape. You want to open. And then you want to go to your Steam Apps. And in order to get to your Steam Apps, you go to your local disk C, Program Files, search up Steam. Then you go to Steam Apps. And this is where we are. Then you go into Common, and all your games should be here. Now, if it's a source mod, it'll be here. This is where I've got the applications, doesn't show up. But yeah, non-Steam as well, you got that there. But either way, we're looking at Insurgency here. I'm going to go into Insurgency. And from this point on, you can practically grab anything. I'm sure this is where your VBKs would be, materials and all that. I haven't had a look at that. I've only really stolen from the workshop, but the one that I made by myself, so that was pretty cool. So anyway, we're going to have a look at, say, mine. You just open it up. You open up the VBK. Yep. You export that somewhere. I put it on here. Oh wait, no, that's an import. Second monitor as well. You open up VTFEdit, and you throw this into this gray box here, and then you have the scope. And then if you want to save it as, say, a PNG or something like that to later edit it, you want to do export. We're going to do this to a desktop. And then do it as a PNG. Trust me, you want to do it as a PNG. Save it. And voila, we have the texture. So it's not that hard to do. It really isn't. So after that, once you have the texture, you can just throw it in. Edit it and whatnot. I'm sure editing skills, you can go search up another video of that. Open recent textures. So this is where I made mine when it loads up. Oh, that's right. Yeah, whatnot. I did it in 64-bit, 32. This is a 64-bit of Photoshop. I did it in 32 version of Photoshop, so yeah. So anyway, this is the texture right here, and you can see that I did make it, because I like to keep my files kind of separate. So if you really do want, I can even post this version up, because I'm going to put this on the workshop. I have a little bit of a blur behind it, just a little added effect, I guess. We got the scope there, so that's what it would look like without that scope, which is pretty cool. So yeah, that's just to show that I actually made it. So I've already got this file, so I don't need to even have to worry about it. It's right here. And you want to make sure that you keep the name. So the name of the scope and all that would be wherever it is that you've stolen it from. I know that this one is Alcan Reptile. I'm not too sure where you would find these names and all that. I just know that this is Alcan Reptile. You got one that's... I just threw it away somewhere. Trust me on that. I've been deleting my workshop so many times over and over and over. We're going to have to view recent. Where's my recent? Date deleted. There we go. So you've also got aimpoint reptile. Rectal, whatever. I don't know that much about guns, so yeah. This is from, I can't remember who his name is, but he's a great texturer, but yeah, so that's that one. I just stole that for no bloody reason. I just wanted to see how the emission worked. So either way, once you have your texture, what you want to do is you want to open up VTFEdit, and you want to throw it in here. Oh, well, sorry. You can't throw in PNGs and all that. You can only throw in VPKs or no VTFs or whatever it is. So what you want to do is you want to go import. I'll show you that again. You want to go file, import. Find your texture. There it is. And with these settings, you just kind of want to leave it on its own. But this is the settings that I've got. I would say maybe copy or anything. I got it to work like this. So, if you want to copy, yeah, that's basically it. 7.2, remember that. I had it on 7.5, and once I changed it back to 7.2, it worked like a charm. So, I would say keep it on 7.2. So, yeah, that's all. Resources, don't worry about that. So, yeah, click OK after that, and it's going to import. Once you have that, I have a picture here somewhere. Where is it? Here it is. I copied my settings. I'm going to throw this onto my second monitor so I can show you. Now, the settings that I did, and the reason why I have settings for this, is because when you put this inside the game, what you're going to get is these white boxes. As well as that, when you put this in the first time, it's going to look something like this. Okay, this is... I don't know what this is. This is really... stupid, I guess you could say, but all you want to do is go up to view, mask, and there you go. And what you're going to get is these really weird anomalies sort of thing, I guess. So basically, this is the alpha mask. There's going to be a little bit too much alpha mask when you import it for some stupid reason. So what I did to stop this And if you have any more ideas and all that in order to stop it, you can go ahead and post it in the comments below. But this is the reason why I'm uploading this tutorial, because it took so long to figure this out and shit. So what you want to do is you want to go no mipmap. And basically what a mipmap is, a mipmap is, I'll show you. That's basically what a mipmap is. So it's a downscale version of it. I'm guessing what the mipmap does is it'll downscale it to where it likes it and all that. So if you turn that off, we'll turn it on, no mipmap. It's basically making it impossible to make a mipmap out of it. So no matter what, it's going to use this HD version. After that, I turn on any sh so I can't even pronounce it. I'm a game developer and I can't even pronounce that. So I turn that on, and basically what that means is, in game development and all that, you've also got it in game options and stuff like that, because it is a little bit expensive on GPUs and all that. What it does is closer textures, they look nice and all that, but further textures, what's going to happen is aliasing is going to occur, where the pixels are basically going to look really chunky and blocky. So what this does is it makes it a lot more smoother and all that, especially for distances. So I turn that on with the hope that it'll make this a lot more smoother, stopping the white border. And when I did turn it on, it did stop the white border, but it was still kind of there and I could still see it. So after that, I did point sample. And what point sample means is that it's going to use the pixels no matter what, the pixels that are there. So it's going to be extremely fine. So if you've got a low resolution texture, I would recommend you make it more high res, because point sample will fuck you over. But basically, it's going to use the pixels that are there. It's not going to try and super sample them or anything like that. It's going to use true textures. So yeah. And then after that, I turn on Trilinear, which will basically make it a little bit more smoother than point sample, look a little bit better, especially for distances and shit like that. So that is my settings. And then after that, what I did is I simply exported it. So what you want to do with this, and I've got my Photoshop right here. So I've got in my Photoshop folder, which is in my documents, Insurgency mods. And then when you go into Insurgency mods, I've got textures, which is my Photoshop document. And then I've got the one that I'm currently working on. And then I've got this. So this rectangle right here is actually the battlefield for M145. Well, yeah, for Insurgency. I completely made it by myself and all that. I just got a picture of it from Google and scaled it up, and then basically copied it over. So yeah, and it looks quite nice, especially in game. So what you want to do first of all is you want to make this folder, which is the name that you want it to be called and all that, under workshop and shit like that. Then after that, you want to make materials, models, weapons, optics, and then finally you can get to your texture. Now when you export this, and I'll show it to you, when you export it, what's going to happen is, let me just get to it. Photoshop, Insurgency. Alrighty. When you get to it, what you want to do is, oh, I'm exporting. Whoops. Save as. Documents. Photoshop, Insurgency. That. So when you get to it, you're going to save it as Alcan Rectile or Rectule. I don't know where the developers named it that. Whether that's American or not, I'm not too sure. Not too sure on that spelling. But either way, what you're going to do is when you save it, I'm going to get a replace option, of course. When you save it, you're going to get two files instead. At least I get two files. If you just get the VTF, then it's perfectly fine. You just do everything with the VTF. But if you do get the VMT, what you want to do is just simply delete it. I discovered that when it has a VMT in it, it just doesn't work. It doesn't want to work for you. I don't know what it is. I'm new to modding. This is the first mod that I've ever actually made, so congratulations to me. I'm a game developer, not a modder. So, just delete that file. I'm not too sure what it really is or anything like that with the source engine. You delete it, and then simply you're perfectly fine. And that's it, basically, for that. You've made your texture, and everything is perfectly fine. Now, the next part to it all is you want to make a new window. Windows key left allows you to do that sort of shit. It's pretty cool. Windows key left. Well, your arrow keys and all that. After that, what you want to do is you want to go to Steam Apps, Common, Insurgency 2, and then you want to go to Bin. Now, there's two ways of finding this file that you need. Now, the most simplest way is by searching VPK. It's an application. The second way is, because you started from the top, is you just go all the way down, and, well, VPK is right there. So, what you want to do is you want to grab this folder that you've made, and it's named whatever you want. You don't grab the materials or anything like that. You grab this folder. Now, you throw it onto VPK. You're going to get the console flash, and then, bingo, you got the VPK. And that is it. You just made a mod. So, from here on, you do exactly what you would usually do with mods. You don't go into custom, you go into insurgency. You go into insurgency, pretty scary. Yeah, then you go into custom, and because I got a lot of mods, I love my mods, then you just throw it straight in here. And there it is for me. Now, what's going to happen is when you throw it in, it's only one file, and know that it is only one file. But when you throw it in, you're going to get, nothing's going to spawn or anything randomly. When you run the game for the first time, it's going to create another one of these or whatever, I guess a brother with it. And it's basically going to be everything lowercase of that, and it's going to add .sound.cache. And that's it. You've got a mod. And yeah, so that's all there is to it. That's, yeah. The part that's going to take you the longest is the making of it. So, yeah. Hope you enjoyed anyway. Hope you have learned something. Hope you don't fuck up. Hope you don't have to go through the pain that I did. I was up all night, so it's 9:42 a.m. right now. I've been working on this ever since 10 p.m. That's how long it took me to figure this shit out. Figure out what applications to install. Figure out how to break into Insurgency and shit like that. Took me quite a while. I didn't really think of searching up for tutorials or anything. I was just an idiot and didn't do that sort of stuff. But guess what? There's only like one or two tutorials, so this will be now the third. So I hope you enjoyed, and I hope you make a good texture so I can download it. See you later, guys, and enjoy.